I once heard a really good quote in a film. I think it was Christina and Vicky do Barcelona. It's about these two girls, totally different backgrounds and ways of living and ways of prioritizing what they're looking for in life and in a relationship. It's a love film. It's a relationship film, romance, and it's cool. You know, these two different girls go to Barcelona and they meet this guy, a really exotic, passionate Spanish guy who's very kind of open and very direct, very passionate. And he says to them that romance dies once love is fulfilled. Romance dies once love is fulfilled. And this quote really hit me, you know. I was like, wow. Like, because I have understood this concept already for quite a while, but I have never heard it expressed so adequately. And I think you could also say it's not just romance, but passion. Because passion is kind of a main ingredient of romance, you could say. Passion dies once love is fulfilled, or once something is completely conquered, you could also say. Something being fulfilled, it's like a cup being full. Once it's full, where's the excitement? You can't pour anything else in. So I think that's one thing which stifles a lot of relationships. You know, you have a lot of people that are meeting each other for the first time, whether it be at a club or a party, introduced through friends. And it's exciting, you know, because there's a certain element of mystery in the end. You're not sure how everything's going to go, whether it's going to work out, whether they're going to like you, whether you're going to like them, how the chemistry is going to be. And it's that novelty, you know, that something new, something fresh, and not knowing the mystery, which I think is truly compelling and which is exciting and makes it feel more passionate. And even then, after you get to know each other and you find the chemistry is working well, there's still, you know, you're not together yet. So there's still this chance that it can go either way, you know, because until it's in the bag, it's out of the bag. And if it's out of the bag, it might wind up in someone else's bag, or it might wind up blowing somewhere else in the winds of change. You never know where things are going to go. So if it's not secured, there's always that chance that, you know, you might lose it, or things might change and go different ways. And I think that also provides the element of mystery, the element of passion and excitement, you know, because it makes you work harder. It makes you appreciate whatever is working out, what time you do share with this person. It makes you appreciate what they choose to give you, because it's not in the bag. You know, so you know, this happens a lot. People meet each other, it's exciting, it's passionate. They start dating for a while, a few months go by, and it's very romantic, very nice, a lot of great feelings, and it's exciting. And then things start to change after quite a few months, and then maybe after people start talking about their feelings, they have the talk, and start doing the whole, well, you can do what you want, but I don't personally feel like seeing anyone else because I really like you at the moment. Oh, really? I really like you too. Oh, let's be exclusive, you know. And then bam, the door closes. And it's like a dam, you know, the water starts building up. All that emotion kind of gets blocked off. I'm not saying completely everything just shuts off, but I'm saying that it changes the flow of things. And often it diminishes the flow. And things, you know, the current doesn't pull as strongly anymore. Things aren't as wild or rushy. And the novelty starts wearing thin, and things start becoming familiar again. The mystery starts getting squeezed out. And I think this is the issue a lot of the time, that people will just jump into commitments with other people. And as soon as you do that, as soon as you fully commit yourself and say, okay, this is it, we're together, we're sorted, no one else, it's like, where's the mystery? You know, you fulfilled the direction you're going, or the thing you're pursuing, whether it be love or a relationship. Fulfilled it, you've conquered it, now passion is dead, and the romance is gone. So that's why, personally, I'm never in a rush to truly commit. I'm a very kind of old-fashioned guy, a bit of a traditionalist, in the sense that, you know, I like to devote myself to a single person. When I meet someone that I really appreciate and grow fond of and respect, and they are special to me, I personally don't feel the need to sleep about or see other people, because, first of all, it kind of tarnishes the feelings that you have. It just makes it feel weird. And I don't know, there's something nice about just having one person, this, whether it be the sentiments or the whatever. That's just me, you know. But I understand things are changing in this era. Women are a lot more empowered and a lot more aware with, you know, about the opportunities that exist abundantly. Plus, there's a greater access now to the opportunities via the internet and Facebook, and there, you know, it's opportunities thrive and they're everywhere. So I think women are a lot less entitled to really settle down, especially when they're young, you know, maybe when they're older and they're starting to move towards the point where they're losing their youth and they've got to maybe start thinking, okay, I've got to settle down, otherwise I'm going to have to settle for whatever I find. So the next best catch I do find, I'm going to keep, because I can't keep playing this game anymore. But when girls are young and they know they've got a lot of years left in their youth and a lot of years left to really thrive in the game, then I don't see any reason why they would settle for less. So, you know, I understand that. Being young, I'm 26. I try dating older women because I just click better with them. I can learn more from them. And it's just they're more mature in some respects. Some respects, they're also a lot more stubborn and closed off in other respects, I find. The ones I've dated anyway. So I reckon a lot of people under, you know, 30, because it doesn't work dating 30-year-olds for me, because they just look down on you. You know, especially if they're mothers, they just look at you as if you're a child and they talk down and like they just know better than you because they're an adult and they're older and they're a parent. And what are you? You're just some young punk. You know what I'm saying? But and I can't date 26-year-olds or people around my age because generally girls around this age won't settle for less. And to be honest with you, I'm a pretty cool cat. I get by and I have a fun life and I can afford, you know, good times here and there. But I'm not a FIFO worker, I don't work in the mines, I don't pull in heavy fat paychecks each week. I don't have my license at the moment because I haven't felt the need to pursue it in a while. And I'm not paying off a mortgage on a house. So in terms of the game, the competition, you know, I don't even have my racing shoes on yet. You know, I'm not even running, whereas people my age, some of them have trophies, or they've already done a few laps of this course, or they're almost at the finish line. You know what I mean? So there's no reason, I think, why anyone would settle for me generally, because girls here, they want the luxury and the comforts. You know, it doesn't mean that it's like, oh, that's all I care about. You know, I'm a polyester girl living in a material world. It's not what I'm saying. But what I am saying that, you know, even if they do look for a nice guy, there's plenty of nice guys out there. There's plenty of charismatic, sweet, attentive, nurturing, sexually satisfying, and, you know, considerate guys, respectful guys out there who also have, you know, full bank accounts and nice cars and a house. You know what I'm saying? Why settle for less? You know, I'm a nice guy, sure, but there's better nice guys out there with more stuff going for them. So I don't really bother committing, at least not this age, or even trying to, you know, promote the idea or talk about it. When I get on with a girl, I generally just ride it out and let it be. And yeah, feelings will develop naturally. And maybe, hopefully, luckily, you know, the girl might come to me and say, hey, I've developed these feelings. I want to devote to you, you know, and actually mean it. Either way, even if they do that, I don't enforce it because I do expect, you know, it's like that song, she'll be coming around the mountain when she comes. It's the same thing, but with opportunities. A girl might think she's at the top of the mountain now, but there's always a corner to the mountain. There's always more things coming. There's always higher peaks. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, and I don't mind doing this. I mean, to me, like I said, this is all about mystery. This is all about passion. This is all about what gives romance and pursuit for happiness via connecting with people and making love and sharing times with each other. It's what makes it special. It's what makes it exciting, is not committing necessarily. I mean, you know, if you feel the need where you've been with someone for quite a while and both of you, just on your own accord, without any talks, any rules, any manipulation or obligations or coercion or intimidation, if you both just on your free will, own accord, want to be together and have been for quite a while, then by all means, name it. Call it what it is and say, hey, we're together. you know. But what I see a lot of people doing is it's like they want the idea of a successful relationship so much, or just a relationship, that they'll find something that just remotely resembles a relationship, that has some nice dynamics going for it, some decent chemistry. Maybe the sex is great and materialism's there, but he's a bit of an asshole. But that's okay, let's hook up. And bam, years later, or just months later, you know, there's regrets, there's looking back, thinking I wasted time, and now I'm damaged. You know, generally you always learn something from new relationships, there's always something good to take away, but some people, there's not as much good as there is bad, and that's because people settle for less. And by less I don't mean, you know, they should go for the next best thing, because there's always better. That's the thing. What I mean is they settle for less than they deserve. You know, like toxic relationships. Just because there's a few elements that work, and people are desperate to have this idea of being with someone. So I think it pays off a lot more if you can actually not rush into things. And, you know, instead of just waiting for things to develop naturally and then calling it for what it is, you know, it doesn't help to meet someone, have a bit of chemistry and say, hey, I'm really interested in you. You're interested in me? Cool. Let's raise the bar up here and call it a fully exclusive, mutually fulfilling relationship, and then try to get to that mark. Try to actually develop our relationship so that we meet that requirement that we've set. I don't see that ever working, and at the end of the day people end up thinking, why did I commit to this when we, you know, now that I've got to know the person or after some time has passed, it's not really working out. And, you know, I wish I didn't make the commitment. It wasn't a valid commitment, that contract I signed. Why did I sign the dotted line? And that's the thing, you don't have to sign the dotted line with anyone. And that doesn't mean that you can't talk about your feelings and you can't say, hey, I like you a lot and I don't feel the need to see anyone else. You can still let someone know that if you want to express to them that they are special to you and that you are happy with just being with them. But this whole thing of mutually pressuring or manipulating each other to make promises and agreements that maybe people aren't really ready to make yet, I think doesn't work. There's no point manipulating someone into your corner and then furthermore even trying to block them from accessing other squares on the board, because that's not what love's about. You can't keep someone with you just by limiting them and pressuring them to stay with you. And that happens. People end up feeling guilty and staying in relationships because they don't know how to break up with the person, or they end up cheating, you know, and then somehow blame it on the other person out of all that resent. And then bam, that's the end of it. Really horrible, messy endings. You know, so I think it's good to feel passion. It's good to feel romance. And it's good when you find something that's working great and it's providing those things to ride out that wave as high as you can. And no need to bring it down. No need to crash it. You know what I'm saying? You don't need to hold something fully committed, fully secured in your hand in order to enjoy it and appreciate it and for it to be worthwhile. You know, and that's why I say, like, I always keep, if not one foot, you know, there's a fence, right? Instead of committing both feet to one side of the fence and fully committing myself to a relationship prematurely, you know, I'll gradually go over the fence and I'll always keep one toe out. You know, I won't be absolutely, you know, in there, absolutely devoted from the get-go or early on, because then things turn stale. You know, before you've really learned to grow on each other properly and bond and appreciate each other sufficiently and deeply, you know, and share those experiences together, you've already committed, you've killed the mystery, the passion, and that's the fuel that you need to actually bond and get to know each other and have all those special moments. So I don't think there's a point to prematurely jumping to one side of the fence. I think it's always good to keep to your own side, even if it's just keeping one toe on your side of the fence. You know, the fact that you're not 100% absolutely, positively, without a doubt, guaranteed committed means that the other person's not going to be taking your ass for granted. You know what I'm saying? Things don't get stale because there's always that 1% chance, you know? And what I mean by that is you might be with someone, you both express that you love each other, you really, you know, you dig each other and you just want to be with each other, but you haven't made any agreements, promises. All you've done is express how you feel. And, you know, there are ground rules, such as, you know, respect, mutual honesty, and communication, and things being open to negotiation. But you don't need to set rules in terms of you can do this, you can't do this. All I think people have the right to do, if they don't want to be possessive, and if they don't want to be basing their relationships on conditional, fear-based, insecurity-based love, if that even exists, is to, instead of saying you can and can't do this, they can communicate how they feel, because that's, you're responsible for yourself, not what the other person does. That's their business. What you can do is say, look, I care about you. I care about you so much that this is, you know, I don't really feel like seeing anyone else. I'm not gonna, you don't have to promise that you won't, but just communicate how you feel, how much the person is special to you. Just express, you know, your regards consistently to let them know where you're at, how you're feeling. You know, don't try to be mysterious in the sense that you're not telling them and you're playing aloof, because that can fuck with people. And then they might go out and do something. You'll be like, why did you do that? And they'll be like, well, you didn't say shit. I didn't know how you felt. So you express your feelings. You got the right to do that. Express your commitments if you want to make a commitment. But don't expect the other person to make a commitment in return or to express the same sentiments. Let them, allow them to use their free will as an independent person in life, and let them decide for themselves how much they like you, how much they're willing to invest and commit to you. You know, a lot of people I see manipulating all that. It never ends well. And yeah, that's all I got to say. So I think I'm just going to take this call. I'll be back in one moment. Sorry, guys.